JeanDecay.
It's subtlety.
This piece is called Bodies That Lie. Frida Kahlo, the most commercially viable Latina communist to have ever existed. She would have hated it. No, she would have hated us. She would have loved the attention. Frida's body was secondary to her image. She had an eye for marketing and was a master at presenting an identity not inherent to her own. You can't deny Frida Kahlo used the same tactics modern capitalist structures use to convince you that buying Nike shoes will change the world. In being perceived as a queer tortured artist whose communist leanings made her for the people, made her a commercial success. And I mean, you go to any radical bookstore or local fair aimed at our community, and somebody is there hawking her image as the pinnacle of a queer Aslan. That under Frida's sovereign image, we come together as queer, brown, disabled, gender non-conforming, anti-fascist communists. Why? Because images are all we have. Because seeing your pain expressed in someone else's face is cathartic. Because like Frida, it's much easier creating your own world where you are everything that you say you are. So we attach who we are to a woman we don't really know. We enable her message because it's much easier to accept her as a radical activist, to accept ourselves as who we believe ourselves to be, and easier for the world to understand who we are. But look at what happened to Malinche. Look at what she represents. Malinche, the warning your tia gives you when you speak a little too much English. Malinche, the name you get when your latinidad isn't enough. A division born not out of her act, but by the world that led up to that circumstance. She was a Nahua woman who was sold to the Mayan slave trade only to be sold to the Spanish. And yet she becomes the La Llorona, drowning her children in the lake. We hate her in the same way we love Frida, because we attach a part of ourselves that we are afraid to own up to. That we, as Latinos, Latinas, and marginalized people, whose pain goes back 500 years, are actually all Malinches. As if one indigenous woman was the cause for colonialism, or that she was somehow more culpable for her actions when she was an inactive participant in even her own livelihood and her own people's societal structure. Who wants to acknowledge their place in acquiescing to dominant culture? So, we continue to hate Malinche, continue to be dishonest on our part in the little oppression of millions of people today. Because we exist on the bones of our people. Because admitting that there were problems even before the Spaniards came is hard to admit. That the myths your mother told you prepared you for a life where you play into a story a better fit into this society. But I guess Frida did what she had to do to survive in society and thrive. Frida, the most profitable Latina communist, and a symbol that no matter how commercialized becomes, is ours. Because images enable us to feel like we can still thrive and be seen in a society that was not designed for us. Look at Arigen. She is literally shrouded in Nahuatl imagery, yet the poster child for zealous Mexican Catholicism. A more palatable Poyashaki, her indigenous blood is forever at odds with her European identity. Her lie that God would save us, but her message to survive lived on. La Virgen, on every liquor store, and the symbol of choice for the farm workers movement. Through our struggles, La Virgen's image is sprawled across canvases and walls. But yet again, we attach ideas to a woman we don't know, or probably didn't exist. Las sangres y las frutas, a dichotomy etched into the cornerstone of our machismo complexes. All of our most famous images are of women, yet somehow we haven't progressed past men who don't know how to keep it in their pants, or past the toxic culture that permeates the femicide of the aquatics. Although it is important to recognize that families of color are far more accepting of their LGBT familia than their white counterparts, so let's not play this game where Latino, black identifying people are somehow more homophobic or more transphobic, because it's all caused by colonization anyways. In any case, we use these symbols, these women, to mark and check off our Latinidad, We judge Malinche, but love Lavihan, or hate Lavihan and worship Frida, as a way to identify who we are within our raza, to mark up, to identify who belongs where. But all any of us are trying to do is survive, like Lavihan, like Malinche, like Frida. But ours is a history of oppression and privilege, about spaces we will never belong to, but then denying that access to others in the same way. So we cope with toxins or stories or deceits. The lies that our family told us about Lavihan, the lies we tell ourselves to escape the constant battle between sides of ourselves that were the result of Malinche's having to do what they needed to survive. But blame's irrelevant. Our history will always be a little muddled. So we use these images to piece together some semblance of a past that was taken away from us. There's a reason why the Spanish burned the codices of the Aztecs, because images were all we have.